worked from an early age. The malnourished children could hardly bear the heavy labor. The masters used sticks and stones to beat them. Sesheng Village is a beautiful place 72 kilometers from Lhasa. It was originally a ranch that belonged to the current Dalai Lama's family. The children here now are content, but some of the old people here are still haunted by the horrible memories of their childhood. Several decades ago, some of the serfs in Sesheng Village fled the unbearable pain. Doma Yudong, who was a teenager then, and her younger brother Chopel also joined that movement. There were two worlds then in Tibet. The people of the master class paid no attention to the other world, as if the others simply did not exist. They indulged themselves, enjoying all that life had to offer, while the poor suffered. This tremendous gap was created by the slavery system and the extremely low productivity. The major masters who maintain the system should be held responsible for such terrible inequity.
欧洲主义世界的分宗教合一的分言论都是没有西藏这么典型，西藏更典型。可是，是这个无托靠有因呢？第一就讲呢，这个全部查出不查，他要修建，可是当然没有了，自己嘛，解决不了。但中国他都有呢，对吧？中国他应该就是对嘛？
这没有军队开的时候呢，作为这个你农奴苦的典型前呢，就是有些西方的研究学者，他们忘了他们的原来中世纪的那一段社会形态对他们社会是造成的什么样的一个后果，他们没有研究清楚，或者是遗忘了。 或者是有意识的不去回顾那一段，还是在西藏，我们对农奴制如何如何对待，这是很不公平的，很不公平的。The
West has long been interested in Tibet. However, it was in this century that their purpose went beyond setting up new missions. The Imperial Britain was once the strongest nation. Had a clear and firm policy in its colony, India, that the border of India would not be threatened at any time. Based on this principle, a buffer area around India under British control was set up. Therefore, Tibet, on the northeastern border of India, had to be independent, friendly to British India, and controlled by the British government. To open the closed gate of the local Tibetan authority, in 1904, an expeditionary army led by Colonel Francis Younghusband crossed the Naidula Pass and launched its invasion of Tibet. The troops passed Yandong, Jiangse, and finally reached Lhasa. It was here in Duna, south of Jiangse, that the British troops encountered the peaceful persuasion and obstruction of the Tibetans and Chinese officials. The result, however, was a massacre of the peaceful hosts by the advanced weaponry of the British. The angry Tibetans decided to resist. They waged a major battle from the fort on Mount Zong in Jansa. Unfortunately, they lost. The shaky central government of the Qing Dynasty and its official in Tibet offered the local Tibetans no support. The 13th Dalai Lama had to flee Tibet. When the British imperial power entered Tibet, it looked for proxies in Tibet and exerted separatism activities through them. Some of the rulers in Tibetan upper caste also began to move towards the British and the Indians. They sent students to Britain and opened an English school in Jiangsu. However, the subsequent Kashgar government punished these people. Their representative, Longshar, had his eyes gouged out and died in the prison. Living Buddha Rodung, a devoted follower of the Chinese government, became regent